Today I'll be showing you how to do a simple neutral eye with a little bit of smokiness added to it. This can be used for any occasion, including school, as well as any formal event. Stay tuned and don't mind the weird faces. Hey guys, welcome to my new channel. It's called Beauty by Shoudie. It's based off my name, Anshuda, because, I mean, Anshuda's kind of a long name, so I just used one of the nicknames that I go by. You guys can call me whatever you want. Shoudie, Anshuda, make up something, whatever's easier for you guys. Let's get started. First things first, girl, get that hair out your face. We don't want any makeup getting your hair. So to start off this look, I'm using CoverGirl CG Smoothers BB Cream, which is more of a tinted moisturizer, in the shade 810 or light to medium, and applying it all over my face with my fingers. I feel like it applies better this way. Make sure to blend really well. Blend, blend, blend. Next, I'm using the e.l.f. Tone Correcting Concealer in the shade Light Beige and applying it to all my imperfections. I don't know why, my finger kind of looks like an ostrich or something, or like my finger's amputated. After applying concealer, I like to do something I call the double chin to make sure my face and neck matches. Always make sure they do. After doing so, I'm applying translucent powder to my face to help set all my face makeup and reduce shine. I chose not to fill in my eyebrows for this look, so I just went ahead to eye makeup. First, start by highlighting the inner corner. How awkward is that? I couldn't even open it. I'm using Snowy White by Jordana, but you can just use any white eyeshadow. I'm applying this with a double-sided sponge applicator by Wet n Wild, using the more pointed end. I find this is easier for me to apply it rather than using a brush. Next, I'm going to apply a light tan colored shadow to my whole lid. Afterwards, I'm using a slightly darker tan color and focusing it more in the crease and using the excess to blend it with the light tan shade. Going in with a brown eyeshadow, I will be adding it to the crease but blending a little bit upwards near the brow bone to get ready for the next color, which would create a gradient rather than harsh lines. As you can see, the look is getting slightly darker. You can even use a blending brush to help blend it before the next step, ensuring a smoother finish. Using a dark brown shade, I'm applying it to the upper crease and part of the brow bone to create more of a smoky look. Make sure to blend though. I can't emphasize this enough. Blending is key in this look. Now we'll be going into the white eyeshadow we used in the beginning as a highlight underneath the eyebrow. I'm going to also use the excess eyeshadow to blend with the dark brown color, also to avoid harsh lines. And now we're all blended. To add more definition to the lower lash line, I will be using the brown color to line it. Now it's time for eyeliner. I'm using the Maybelline Eye Studio in Black is Black. Unfortunately, I couldn't find the brush it came with. I'm using a different eyeliner brush instead. You can create two different styles, either a slightly defined look or a more defined look. I chose to go with a more defined look. I had to step out of the room for a bit and I really gotta hold the camera. Anyways, mascara time! But wait, can't forget to curl our eyelashes. So curl them and then apply mascara. But I am using Maybelline's The Rocket Mascara in Black is Black and applying this to both top and bottom lashes. If you apply the mascara close to your bottom lash line, it will act as an eyeliner. Little tip if you're running short on time or want to define them without actually applying eyeliner. As well. Onto the lip. First, you gotta moisturize them, girl. And nobody wants chapped lips. So I'm using the Peppermint Baby Lips all over my lips. For lipstick, I'm using Wet n Wild Smokin' Hot Pink. And yep, that mop just came out of nowhere. Probably shouldn't have left my window open. I'm just dabbing the lipstick for a little bit of color. This step is optional, but I wanted a little more shine, so I'm using a pink lip gloss and putting it on my lips. This step is also optional, but I chose to apply some light pink blush to add a splash of color to my face. And you're done! Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!
Please tell me you've seen that bike, because that'd be really awkward. I'm gonna say Shoudie by Beauty.
Do 12.
3. And 4. And 1.
Showtime. That is so awkward.
Alright. I guess I'm done for today.
So was that good?